Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. आज की वीडियो is the most demanded video ever. And बहुत सारे लोगों को लगता है कि LMIA, which is job offer from India, which is LMIA approved, it's very easy to get, but it's not. And आज हमने एक नहीं बल्कि दो लोगों को invite करा है जो यहाँ पे आए थे इंडिया से जॉब लेके विद एन LMIA approved work visa. And ये दोनों के profiles are very different. The reasons why they got the job is very different, and we'll actually just interview that so that you get a perspective कि क्या चाहिए in your profile to get a genuine LMIA offer. So जिन लोगों को नहीं पता ये definition है LMIA की, LMIA is basically labor market impact assessment, which is a document जो हर employer को चाहिए to prove to the Canadian government कि हमें बाहर से कैंडिडेट लेना पड़ेगा क्योंकि वो कैंडिडेट हमें इंटरनली नहीं मिल रहा है. एंड अगर गवर्नमेंट जो है वो अग्री कर जाए तो उसको वो बोलते हैं पॉजिटिव LMIA. अगर पॉजिटिवली में आ गया देन यू कैन अप्लाई फॉर अ वर्क परमिट. तो चलो मिलते हैं जसदीप और हबीब से.
फर्स्ट यू नो वी विल टॉक अबाउट हबीब. सो हबीब, जस्ट इंट्रोड्यूस योरसेल्फ, वेयर यू आर फ्रॉम एंड यू नो व्हाट डू यू डू.
Actually from India in Mumbai. I've been staying for like 15 to 16 years. And then I came to Montreal last year, July. And I stayed in Montreal for 5 months. Last year, December, I moved. And in Toronto, I have got another job. That's why I moved to Toronto. So in last 1 year, I got 2 job offers, which was LMIA, which we'll talk about later. Mm-hmm. But yeah, it's, and I moved here with my family, like my wife and I have a baby. Okay. So we all three came together. So here we are staying in Toronto now.
Okay. And what do you do, Habib? So let's talk about that.
For Hollywood movies and Netflix series, Amazon Prime series kind of thing. So VFX, you might know or might not know. It's like when movie gets shoot, after that there's FX, which you might have seen, like Avengers and a lot of other movies, Alita Battle Angel and a lot of other movies. So I worked on several Hollywood movies, several TV series.
All right. That's a pretty cool role, and no wonder that you got employers fighting for you. So that's good. Let's move to Jasdeep. So Jasdeep, first tell us where you are from and then what you do.
Hey, I'm from India, Punjab, and I started my career back in 2007. So initially, like, it was app development, but slowly, gradually, I get into this space of cybersecurity. It was not booming at that time, but recently, when there are many banks and many financial institutions that just like compliance towards the security transactions and all, so they have to meet a criteria, and then suddenly the need of cybersecurity, and also, you know, there are so many cyber threats and crimes going over and around, and you got to have that level of protection. So this space just bumped up a lot. There is lots of requirements going on around.
Now, Habib, let's switch into LMIA and try to understand how you managed that. Were you still in India? Like, did you have interviews? How did you apply for it? So what was the process for you?
Actually, when I applied for a job, I did not know about LMIA. I applied for quite a few jobs on LinkedIn and like for a few major companies. And after applying, within a month or so, I started getting interview calls. And then I have gone through interview with two major companies. Mm-hmm. And then both of them said, there will be a like process. They are ready to sponsor. There'll be a visa process, which was like approximately a few months, 4 to 5 months. And then by February 2018, I got another job offer from a different company. Mm. There is a big company. Then they said they can process my LMIA and visa and everything quite fast. So I spoke to first company. I said, since I'm getting this job offer, what do you say? They said their process is quite slow because they're a small company. So you can go ahead with that offer. And then we'll see in future. So I accepted second offer. And then they processed my visa, but it took approximately 2.5 to 3 months for complete process because I had to serve my notice period in my previous company in Mumbai. So after completing everything by month of July, I came to Montreal, and that LMIA process was not very complex because I did not know initially what is LMIA. I was not chasing for them. Employer was the responsible person for doing all those things. And when I came here in Montreal, So after landing, we got work permit on airport. So we had visa stamped on our passport. So that was a smooth process. And we got lucky that, I mean, we haven't fought that much for that.
So, Jazzy, what was your experience? Like, we understand that Habib's experience was very different. He didn't even know what LMIA is. So, it was on the employer. So, how about you?
So, for me, I was pretty aware of LMIA before. And I was, like, looking for coming to Canada at that time. Because, like, my age was... I was also thinking to apply for a PR. So, so I had niche technology as Habib has. But... I started building my profile and looking for contacts. Since I was quite old in the market, I was able to get people who is working in a Canadian company. My experience were distributed over various clients and various tools that are there in the market. So it just kind of made my profile a bit interesting. And yeah, that's why I was able to get a LMIA offer. This company a while to take a decision, because like taking a decision to hire a person who you haven't met physically, and also who is not in Canada and who is just like in India, and just pulling him in directly is always trickier. But I was able to convince them, and again based on my contacts, because I was able to give a reference to of the people in different parts of America. In South America, I was able to give references. In pretty good companies, they would have called them and asked them my work and all. It's just how I kind of...
Do you have worked globally? That's why this happened? Or is it that you had contacts, like you explored contacts? How did you get those contacts?
Yeah, so working globally and establishing contacts, they always go hand in hand. In US, where I worked in a very reputed company who was my customer. Okay. And there I met, could establish a connection, good connection with them. And I also took their help to refer me when they were asking for it.
Okay. Okay. So, you got references from all over the world, especially, you know, in Americas. And
in America.
Yeah. But would you say, also, you know, Habib's experience, so, you know, Habib's profile is very unique. So, you know, it would be, I won't say easier, but there would be more people who would be wanting him, because there are very few people probably in his field. But would you say that, Jasdeep, for your profile, is it that it's a rare profile or is it just the references that work for you?
My profile is not, I shouldn't say it's rare, and it's not very common. It's decent. It's decent.
Okay.
Because working in different tools in this market and over years, they definitely ask you many questions. But I should also say that maybe 50% contacts mattered a lot.
Okay.
Because of the I was not there in Canada. And they have to have that faith that this employer, that this guy, this employee will be a genuine one. So for me, like it worked both way. I have a decent profile as well as I have good references all over in Americas.
And Habib, so you said that you did not play a massive role in the entire process. But what is it that would happen now? Now that you have LMIA, are you looking to convert that into PR?
Actually, my first year is going to complete by next month. So then I can apply for experience category for PR. Definitely, I'll be going for PR application. I have to just, then once my IELTS score will come, if that is good enough, then definitely I'll file. And I hope my points would be good enough.
अब गाइस जसदीप और हबीब जैसे बहुत सारे ऐसे लोग हैं जिनकी एज जो है वो कंड्यूसिव नहीं है एक्सप्रेस एंट्री के लिए. उनके पास मास्टर्स डिग्री नहीं है, एक्सपीरियंस बहुत ज़्यादा है CLB 9 और स्पाउस बैचलर्स और CLB 9 के बावजूद उनका स्कोर जो है वो 386 बनता है जस्ट बिकॉज एज जो है वो बहुत ज़्यादा है. इस केस में हबीब और जसदीप जैसे थोड़े से लोग ऐसे होते हैं जो कि कैनेडा आ पाते हैं वर्क परमिट पे, वो एक साल का कनेडियन वर्क एक्सपीरियंस जो है वो एक्यूमुलेट करते हैं और उसके बाद वो अपने एम्प्लॉयर से बात करके एक साल का और जॉब ऑफर अपना एक्सटेंड करा के लीमिया ले लेते हैं. एंड उसके बाद जो स्कोर बनता है वो 484, despite 38 years of age and only bachelor's degree, unka score almost 100 points se jump kar jata hai.
So actually, when I came, so the employer who has given me LMIA, they asked me if my wife is going to work here, if they need, she need work permit or visitor visa.
Mm-hmm.
So that was my choice. So I thought if I'll be applying for a work permit, then that might take a little bit longer. So anyway, she was not having any plan to work that time. So I said, oh, she'll be staying here on visitor. And then we got visitor visa. After coming here, then I got to know that both visa takes same time, actually. It doesn't, I mean, if she's on work permit, it's better for us. Maybe she'll get SIN number. If she's not on work permit, to get any internet connection, phone connection, or any kind of credit card, debit card, bank account, whatever.
The work permit mentions the LMIA number.
Mm-hmm.
It's a positive LMIA number, along with all the facilities that we can have in Canada.
Okay.
So for me, it's written that you can only work for this employer.
Okay.
And you can, and in my daughter's work permit, she has also, it's not a work permit, but she has also a legal copy where it's mentioned you can attain education till this level.
Okay.
And to my wife, it's like you can work in any employer. So those conditions are there in that legal document.
Versus a PR, I know that, you know, there are some more subsidies if you are a PR holder. You get something from the Ontarian government as well. But how does it work for work permit?
Like, okay, so yeah, it's a good question. So we do not get CCB on the first thing. Okay, CCB, that's child care benefit, is only available for PRs and citizens or for work permit who has already worked successfully for 18 months.
Okay.
Still have a job offer. And for the regular health cards, we do have the same health cards that we have for PRs.
And there's also another condition for health card. If we are having contract less than 6 months or work permit less than 6 months, then we will not get health card. It has to be more than 6 months.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah. Same goes for driving license. So if we are going to apply for driving license, our contract and work permit has to be more than 6 months.
Also, the problem that I faced is that the bankers were never comfortable giving me a credit card.
Oh.
So it took me 3 months to show my 3 months salary. And then I get a credit card and that too with the minimum credit limit.
Guys, thanks a lot. I think we have discovered, you know, we have covered the challenges. We have covered the linear process. We have covered, you know, your specific profiles. It's very clear that Habib, you know, you had a very different profile in a very niche kind of an industry. And that's why, you know, you had jobs lined up. And Jasdeep, from your experience, it's very clear that you had very strong references. You were able to get global references and that helped you.
The whole idea of making this video was ki LMIA, bahut sare na hume messages aate hain, jisme log kehte hain ki yaar, hume job offer chahiye, hamare ko na 1 lakh rupaye, 10 lakh rupaye, 5 lakh rupaye lekar koi ek banda hai jo hume job offer de raha hai. It's not that easy to get a job offer, and you either need very strong references or you need a very different profile in order to get a job offer and get an LMIA. You know, the employer has to do a lot of work in order to apply for an LMIA. And वो सब काम करने के लिए you need to have something different in your profile. So guys, अगर वीडियो पसंद आई तो प्लीज लाइक करके जाना, and for more such videos do subscribe to our channel. मिलते हैं अगली वीडियो में, तब तक के लिए bye bye.